All right, well, I got the package finally from UPS, and it's kind of torn. I've already opened a little bit, but it's kind of weird. What? Very bad quality. Anyway, I'm happy. Let's see what we got here. Close the door. All right, well, it's kind of hard holding the camera and opening stuff at the same time, but hey, look, air, what else we got in there? Oh, that's nice. 25 free downloads of eMusic. Does anyone ever use that anymore? Moving on, what else we got in there? Ooh, break free, ooh, this is kind of cool. Never mind. Let's focus. And voila! There we go. The PlayStation 3 adapter. Ah. I've been waiting for this thing whole 3 days. Well, let's open it up. Alright, well, we got rid of the really hard to open packaging. And, well, first look. It's really. Alright, so it looks awesome. Let's plug it in and see what happens when we'll try to play Guitar Hero. Yeah, all right. That's what I'm talking about. So cool, everything works. Well, kind of. So as you saw, Guitar Hero 1 works perfect. Now, let's see how Guitar Hero 2 will do. Alright, so the Wind Bar works and that's great, but if you just started playing Guitar Hero, this adapter is not gonna help you learn, because when you hold the fret buttons, they don't light up on the screen. Just as well, this is not for hardcore gamers because you can't do hammer-ons or pull-offs. Also, you can't hit notes right for some reason.
Oh, come on! Stupid!
Alright, so overall, it's a good attempt to bring a Guitar Hero action to the PS3, but it's not very good. It works great with Guitar Hero, but you can't do hammer-ons or pull-offs, and in order to perform Star Power, you gotta press the select button. On the other hand, Guitar Hero 2 is even worse. I mean, it's just crappy. So you just buy this for this game, and that's it.
Boy, you suck!